And welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. What we've done is take regular Countdown and made it bigger, looser and ruder, a bit like your mum. Did you know, according to lexicographers, 40 is the only number that, when written down, has all its letters in alphabetical order? Interestingly, 40 is also how old most lexicographers are before they see a naked lady. The word crap comes from the last name of the person that invented the toilet, Thomas Crapper, narrowly beating designs by Thomas Schitter. And Thomas, I'd leave that 10 minutes if I were you. Palindromes are words or phrases that read the same in both directions. My favourite palindromes that I've ever come across are tit and boob. Did you know, for example, council workers in Glamorgan were left embarrassed after they spelt Wales, W-H-A-L-E-S, on road signs? To be fair, it should be pretty obvious whether you're entering a Welsh town or driving into the dark, reeking guts of a giant sea creature. Unless it's Swansea, in which case better signage would help. And children know at least one obscene word by the age of 2, but that's only if you consider the words poo and willy obscene, which they are if you do what I do with them. Did you know, for example, the average Brit knows about 50,000 words, but for some reason they can't remember any of them whilst playing along with Countdown? Americans call mathematics math, arguing that mathematics functions as a singular noun, so math should be singular too. But then again, they also call bums fanny, so what do they know? And the world record for the most swear words in a television programme is 201 in a half hour, and that's the last time Sean's getting invited on Loose Women. Did you know, for example, some words only exist in plural form? For example, binoculars, scissors, trousers, jeans, pants and Jedward. Singlish is the nickname for the variety of English spoken in Singapore. Singlish is also my response if my girlfriend's away and an attractive woman asks me, are you single? Singlish. And a professor at the University of Houston said it would take 31,688 years to count to 1 trillion. So to do it, you'd need to love maths and be over 31,000 years old. Sounds like a job for Vorderman. Did you know, for example, if all the letters ever selected on Countdown were laid out next to each other, they'd stretch for more than 20 miles. And even then, Sean couldn't make a 9-letter word. The most common first word for a baby in Newcastle is dad, usually in the sentence, when is me dad getting out of prison? And the 27 Club is the name given to a group of musicians who all died at the age of 27. Its members include Jimi Hendrix, Kurt Cobain, Amy Winehouse and, fingers crossed, Justin Bieber. Did you know, for example, in 1623, the astronomer Galileo Galilei observed that the entire universe is written in the language of mathematics? He did very well, considering he was just a poor boy from a poor family. A recent survey revealed that 61% of Brits can't speak a second language, and in Glasgow, many people can't even speak their first. And the official name for man boobs is gynecomastia. You'll find gynecomastia in the dictionary and under your dad's T-shirt. Did you know, for example, most European languages belong to 3 broad groups, Germanic, Slavic and Romance? I don't know much about Germanic or Slavic, but I do know how to speak the Romance languages. Would you like to see my winkle? In the first ever dictionary, Samuel Johnson famously defined oats as a grain which in England is generally given to horses, but in Scotland supports the people. Nowadays, of course, that definition doesn't work for oats, although it does work for ketamine. And a podysophilia is a feverish desire to undress and get naked in public. It sometimes affects old and confused people, like Madonna. Did you know, for example, each animal has its own specific mating call? A badger shrieks, a fox clickets, a goat rattles, a deer croons, and a jimmy begs. The average American eats 28 pigs in a lifetime. Sorry, that should read, in a lunchtime. And on average, it takes 7 minutes to fall asleep. Here's a little tip if you're having trouble falling asleep. Why not ask my girlfriend what sort of a day she had? Did you know, for example, the inventor of the telephone, Alexander Graham Bell, suggested all phone calls begin with the words ahoy hoy, as in the sentence, ahoy hoy, have you been missold PPI? There is an Amazonian tribe that only has three numbers. One, two, and many. And even they beat Sean at Countdown. And cats can jump five times their own height, or even more if you've taped a firework to their bum. Did you know, for example, according to Shakespeare, there are seven stages of man, and I can name all seven. There's newborn baby, young boy, immature man, immature man, immature man, immature man, dead. To be xanthodontic means to have yellow teeth. I wouldn't know about yellow teeth. Mine are so bright I have to dip them when I drive at night. And a Nebuchadnezzar is equivalent to 20 bottles of wine, which in turn is equivalent to a quiet night in for Sean. Did you know, for example, Lionel Blair's is Cockney rhyming slang for flares, whereas Tony Blair's is Cockney rhyming slang for a Jeremy Hunt. 13,350 people in the UK are over the age of 100, and that's just one reason why Countdown keeps on getting recommissioned. And in Thailand, 555 is slang for ha-ha-ha, because the word five is pronounced ha, and can be used in sentences such as, 555, Mr. Jimmy, you thought I was lady, but too late, we married now. 555. Did you know, for example, FOMO stands for fear of missing out? It's when someone worries they're missing out on something interesting happening elsewhere. It's mainly experienced by people talking to John Richardson. A French mathematician has developed an equation to explain why hipsters aim to dress like individuals but end up all looking the same. And the equation is beard plus breakfast cereal cafe divided by vegan bicycle repair shop minus sense of irony equals dickhead. And quotation marks were invented 300 years ago and were originally used in the sentence, happy 30th birthday, Carol Vorderman. Did you know, for example, in Danish, Lego literally translates as play well? Lego is so versatile. It doesn't matter whether you want to tread on something painful, get something lodged up a child's nose, or choke a pet to death. Lego has the perfect brick for you. A moment was originally defined as 1/40th of an hour or 90 seconds. It can be used in phrases such as, would you like to have sex with me? It'll only take a moment. The expression, born with a silver spoon in his mouth, means being born into a rich family, whilst the expression, born with a silver spoon in one hand and a lighter in the other, means born in Glasgow. Did you know, for example, 5 years after starting work on the Oxford English Dictionary, the editors were still on the word ant, and that was because they couldn't remember if he was the shorter one or the one with the massive forehead. The first ever text message was sent in December 1992 with the words, Merry Christmas. And the reply was, who dis? And the number 007 is not only James Bond's code name, but also the dialing code for Russia. Coincidence? Yeah, coincidence. Did you know, for example, in China, they reckon you need to know about 2,000 Chinese characters to read a newspaper. But sadly, the only Chinese characters I know are Bruce Lee and Jackie Chan. William Shakespeare wrote 37 plays. I love Shakespeare. He's great for people who want a night out of the theatre, but they don't want all the hassle of understanding it or enjoying themselves. And the word snurtle means to suppress a laugh and can be used in phrases such as, every time Jimmy took off his trousers, the girl snurtled. Did you know, for example, garbology is the technical term for the study of rubbish, although garbology is probably more commonly known as media studies. A misopogonist is someone who hates beards. I hate men with beards. They're untidy, they're dirty, and they really tickle my balls. And the term mansplaining refers to a man explaining something in a patronising way to a woman who actually knows more about the subject than he does. Got that, Susie? Did you know, for example, 100 million is the number of M&Ms that are consumed every day in America? And looking at Americans, I think that's per person. Although in Britain we use a decimal point, in much of Europe they use a comma. They are wrong and we are right. Full stop. And 72 is the average number of days women will spend shaving their legs in a lifetime. I bet they're jealous of men like John Richardson who aren't able to grow hair anywhere on their bodies. Did you know, for example, the country Iceland was originally called Butterland, whilst neighbouring Greenland was known as I Can't Believe It's Not Butterland? The Albanian language has 30 words for eyebrows, but unfortunately, no word for tweezers. And the original name of Winnie the Pooh was Edward the Bear. It turns out Winnie the Pooh was just his stripper name. Did you know, for example, hypothermia is a state in which the core temperature of the body falls below 35 degrees? People who die from it include mountaineers and, during a cold snap, viewers of Regular Countdown. A Victorian slang term for a vagina was a crinkle crankum. I find it fascinating. I love looking up things like that. And to obnunciate is to announce bad news, as used in the sentence, the shopkeeper obnunciated, I'm sorry, Rachel, but we only have that particular dress in a child size.
Saves on VAT, you'd know all about that, Jimmy.
Saves on VAT. Did you know, for example, the Hungarian language has only one word meaning son or daughter? That's nothing. Cornish uses only one word to mean wife, mother and lover. And that word is sister. Only one in five employers has the patience to finish reading a CV, which is pretty disrespectful because people spend hours making that shit up. And one in 10 Americans think the computer language HTML is a sexually transmitted disease. Presumably, they think you get it by sticking your hard drive into someone's Yahoo. Did you know, for example, misophonia is an intolerance for certain annoying or grating sounds? For example, nails on a chalkboard, power drills, or John Richardson's voice. A factotum is a person who does all kinds of menial jobs. Menial jobs like taking the bins out or doing the washing up or putting jumbled up letters on a board.
Someone's got to do it.
Thanks for helping out. And English is the most spoken language in the world. It's the international language of air traffic control, business communications, scientific publications, and jokes about how fat your mum is. Did you know, for example, it would take you 80,000 years to read the entire catalogue of the British Library? But you'll never do it, because it shuts at 5. In Greek, the word for left-handed also means better, and it's better because it feels like someone else is doing it. And the word amungdery describes a bodily organ that discharges waste. For example, your arse or Donald Trump's mouth. Did you know, for example, 27 is the age Vincent van Gogh began his artistic career, but he had to give up painting just 10 years later because, for some reason, his glasses kept falling off. A whimling is a weak or childish person, more commonly known as John Richardson. And plap is an onomatopoeic term for a light slapping sound. It's the sort of thing you might hear when your mum's reading 50 Shades of Grey.